take a look at our 67% chest. And we've done over 100,000 damage. That's amazing. Okay. Let's get some rest. I slept like a log. Alright. All the side dungeons are done. For the Earth Crystal. We'll have one final set of things to do. After we beat the next real objective. So, we were going to what? The Ancient's Maze next. That's right. The Ancient's Maze. So we need to get off of this. I assume we just fly off and it'll get us there. Yep, that works. And we are going this direction. For quite a while. Do a little check on something. Everything looks pretty good. All right. Yeah, this is gonna look pretty different when it actually, like, when I'm segmenting things up, because, like, each dungeon is gonna take longer. I'm probably gonna have hour-long episodes on this compared to the previous two. And I feel like the other games, it's just gonna go like that, because these games just get bigger. These first two games are... they're bigger than you think, but really you can run through them pretty fast. This one you can't, there's only a certain speed you can go. The battles play out slower in general. Whoops, that's not what I meant to do. Okay. Ancient's Maze. That's where the Earth Crystal was. Suppose you might want to start seeing some of these summons. I'll do that in the next few battles. I'll show you each of these summons. Like the full power ones. Chocobo's gonna be weak, obviously. I could boost the next couple turns. Look how many charges you get of these summons. Like, look at that. Woo! 13 fucking Bahamuts? Who needs 13 Bahamuts, 27 Leviathans, and 36 Odins? Summoner, like, has got a big advantage against the Magus in that way. Like, they get so many charges of their spells. Still need to get level 8 magic. an elixir. Why, thank you. I see what else was over here. I guess you would like to see defeat. A lot of damage, must have been weak to fire. Earth and Fury. I'm gonna turn off the encounter rate after I show you all these summons too. Speed up our adventuring. Oh, you're on a horse, huh? I know someone else is on a horse. Instant death, obviously, but it's a much higher rate than other instant death abilities. I kind of like what they did in 9, where you can put an item on so he can do wind damage if he happens to whiff, you know? He swung so hard with such a big sword it still damages enemies. I thought that was a neat idea. Now, Leviathan is gonna do some serious damage. You know what? Let's do this. I do want to give him good weapons. Alright. I want to give him the best weapons of their type at the very least. I know I said I wasn't going to do that a second ago, but I want to do it. Alright. Oracle. Ninja. I'll make her do slot 3. Yeah. Devout. Sage. So in the NES versions, the Ninja and Sage came later. I think I said this before, but they were significantly better. For instance, the Sage could use the high summons, and they had a lot more charges of stuff, and they were just better. That's okay. That's okay, though. You got those, you got those, you got that. You're gonna get the rods. That'll give him some extra attack options. Not that he really needs them. Black Mage. Okay. And he's back to being summoner. Ribbons are really useful. You don't really want to replace those. You can use the Shura gloves. Nothing wrong with a little solid defense, right? Mm-hmm. Oh, and she could use the angel robes, that's right. I wonder how this compares to the red jacket. It makes less sense thematically. The summoner and the sage coming from white mage and black mage makes sense. The monk gear on the black belt makes sense. Red mage on Ingus doesn't make much sense. Dark Knight does. Alright. Let's get this going. Turn off this encounter rate, right? That's what I said I'd do. Be on the lookout for treasure chests. Crystal gear. Good shit. Excuse me. Oh, it goes right. It goes down here. I love the black belt outfit. Break blade. I love that weapon. Break blade and blood sword. That's a cool combo. I'm trying to think of... I wish there was more spellcasting swords in this game, like there were in the previous two. It fit Red Mage and Sage better, I feel like, but... Hell, it even fit the Scholar to be able to use spellcasting weapons. Oh well. Especially if you never mind. Red mage from then scholar then sage, that could be an upgrade path. I don't know. They all can cast a combo of magic. Hold on, can I go up? No, that's always a no. They hand you a lot of good gear in this one. Just like, literally just give it to you like this. I guess it's because there's so many classes. Chances are half the shit is not gonna be useful to you. Okay, guys. So basically, what I did right there is I filled out the bestiary mostly. Let's see. I think we step inside here. Now that we've entered that, it'll count it, and we can leave. Okay. So, here's how to check. We should have some new stuff in Taka, I believe. Or maybe not. Hold on. We do have Bahamut, right? Yeah. That's not infinite items. What the hell's going on here? Monsters collected. We should have more than that. Did I just load an old save? I'll be damned if I did. Hold on. Hold on a second. I see. Okay. I misspoke. Okay. So, here's the first thing we're gonna do. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna return to our home village. Which is pretty far away, actually. Doodly doodly do do. Man, this is the slowest airship in any Final Fantasy game. In terms of, like, getting across the map. At least it feels like it, because there's just so much empty sea everywhere. Alright, return to our home. Oh, shit. Papa's in here, right? To Altair Cave. Well, Luna's mother doesn't have anything else to say except for one line in the game. It's a tutorial. Okay. Let's go rescue some kids. Look at this. Easy peasy. Oh, here you guys, you didn't get to see. Bomb it yet, did you? Well, here's your chance. Freaking dead. And there, we've unlocked the last job, Onion Knight. Onion Knight is incredibly weak until it hits level 92, and then it gains 12 in every stat each level. At level 99, it's a max stat. So yes, it's, and it can cast all white and black, all magic. It can cast all magic. And equipped all weapons and equipment. So it is the best class in the game. We'll switch to it in a little bit. We'll play with this, with these classes a bit more. Okay. Now that we've done that, let's go visit Sarah. Angus, you can lead for that. Sarah's in the East Tower, I think. Angus, you've come. This is the pendant I told you about in my mail. It's very important to me. Do you know anyone who could fix it? Sarah's pendant. Alright. It's side quest in time, basically, guys. Okay. So, who's gonna give us, who's gonna help us? First, we're gonna go see Taka. All right, now we're gonna go. To Saronia. Yep, we just keep going and going and going, don't we? Silly. So in northwestern Saronia, we're gonna find the legendary smith. She has white hair, that's how you can identify her. Hmm. She's on the east side of town. There we go. It's all fixed. There's one item, however, that I would like to ask you to find for me. What may that be? Have you ever heard of Orichalcum? Orichalcum. I've never known how to pronounce this. Orichalcum. It sounds more than fair. Okay. I think she can also give us stuff for our master jobs. Maybe it can't be in the same conversation, though. Or maybe it's after we give her Orichalcum. Either way, we have Sarah's thing back now. Yes, there's a lot of back and forth. Meet old Sarah. Okay. My pendant, you fixed it.